We request the government to approve the revised cost estimate at an earlier date. We are thankful for the commitment given by the Honorable Finance Minister and Water Resource Minister. They have given a oral commitment also. We are grateful to you, ma'am, for that. But anything without the cabinet approving it, it will not be fruitful. So it is, the Polavaram project is going on a very brisk phase right now. And Polavaram project is slated to be completed next year. So we request the government to act fast on this and approve the revised cost estimate. And coming to the other issue of medical colleges, so post bifurcation, we don't have tier one cities in Andhra Pradesh apart from Visakhapatnam. So not in much private people are coming forward to set up super specialty hospitals. So our chief minister has come forward to construct 16 new medical colleges and super specialty hospitals. So we request the central government to help us out, because when there's no private people coming in, there's only option is a public sector investment in that. So even if you see pro rata compared to the other states, the number of medical colleges in Andhra Pradesh is very, very less. So we request the government to take care of this, because we have seen in the pandemic how important it is for medical department to be equipped properly.
Members from Andhra Pradesh, especially from different parties, have been speaking about this finance bill or demand for grants for the last 7 years since the bifurcation of Andhra Pradesh. The demands have still remained the same, and I would like to just repeat some of them, which are very, very important even today, which is the special status, bridging of resource gap, Polavaram project, formation of railway zone, metro, road, rail projects, establishment of Vizag Chennai corridor, construction of educational institutions, and many more. So they are still pending on behalf of the central government, whereas financial assistance is required. So through the finance bill also, I would request the Ministry of Finance to speed up this process, as 8 years has already finished since the Bifurcation Act has been started implementation. So I would request the Honorable Minister to release the rest of the funds. But Madam, today I would like to talk about the most burning issue in the state of Andhra Pradesh, which is the privatization of Vizag steel plant. An in-principle agreement has been taken by the cabinet saying that 100% disinvestment should be made in RINL Vizag steel plant. On behalf of Telugu Desam Party and the people of Andhra Pradesh, we totally oppose this decision of privatization of Vizag steel plant, Madam. And I would like to present my case by talking about the history of the inception of this plant. Around 7 to 8 years, under the slogan of Vishaka Ukku Andhrula Hakku, which means the steel of Vizag is the right of Andhra, the people of both Telangana and Andhra Pradesh came together and fought with the center for the establishment of the steel plant. 32 people have lost their lives. 22,000 farmers have donated their lands for the establishment of this plant. So today, even if the owners of this plant is the central government, they have to realize that it was made on the sacrifices of the Telugu people, Madam. If the central government has a big heart, then they would realize that privatization of this Vizag steel plant is not the right decision. But I see that they have conveniently ignored all the emotions and sentiments of the Telugu people, and they are going with a separate argument. And one of the arguments being made is that Vizag steel plant is a sick unit. I beg to differ, Madam. I'd like to place some of the stats on record, where it is between 2000 and 2015, the turnover has been 1.4 lakh crores and profits after taxes of 12,600 crores. And for 13 consecutive years, it exceeded 100% capacity utilization. Vizag steel plant has achieved an all-time high of 1.3 million tons in exports. And recently, in times of COVID also, the workers have worked putting their lives at risk. And December 2020, profit of 212 crores. Jan 2021, 134 crores profit. Feb 2021, 165 crores profit. And this present month, they're expecting 300 plus crores profit. So I beg to differ whenever they say that Vizag steel plant is a sick unit. And the second argument being made by the central government often when it comes to disinvestment of PSUs is that we shouldn't waste taxpayers' money in these sick units. First of all, I explained it's not a sick unit. But the second argument, where taxpayers' money is being used, I'd like to present my case here also. Since the inception of the Vizag steel plant, the contribution from the central government to the plant has been 4,900 crores in terms of equity and 1,300 crores in terms of restructuring package. So the total amount given is 6,200 crores. But what has the Vizag steel plant paid back to the central government? It is up to the tune of 43,000 crores. It is 5 times more than what the central government has donated, has given to the Vizag steel plant. So 43,000 crores in terms of taxes and dividends has been paid back. But what we request from the central government to do to the Vizag steel plant, there are a couple of demands, and these are not demands of just me or the people of Andhra Pradesh. Standing committees have demanded on behalf of Vizag steel plant that they have to be given captive mines. Sale units, other steel plants, they are getting captive mines, they have captive mines, and they are getting per ton of steel at 1500 rupees. Whereas Vizag steel plant, because it doesn't have the captive mine, it is getting at 7000 rupees. And what is this amounting to? VSP loses 5260 crores for every ton of steel it sells, and which is translated to a loss of 2300 crores in the last fiscal year alone. So what we really request from the central government, if they want to help the Vizag steel plant, is that they should cater for captive mines for this and provide a level playing field just like other steel plants. And the other thing we are requesting is to reduce the interest rates. When Tata steel plant is getting loans from the banks at 8% interest rate, Vizag steel plant, which is under the finance department, which is under the central government, it is getting at 14%. And this again is resulting in losses up to the fact of 1500 crores just in interest payments, madam. And there are other solutions also. Why not club SAIL and RINL together and try to take everyone in the same line? That is not being done. And when it comes to the exports of this iron ore, 82% of our total iron ore exports goes to China. We are blocking apps from China. We are trying to see that Made in India be boosted. Now 80% of iron ore is going to China, and China accounts for all the global steel output. When you have such good functioning steel plants within the country, why don't you give the existing iron ore to them and help them, which is under your own care? So this is what we are requesting. Why show the stepmotherly treatment towards Andhra? And I'm saying stepmotherly because on 16th of March, the Honorable Minister of Heavy Industries, I'll complete in 1 minute, madam. Heavy Industries and Public Enterprises says on the floor of the house that those PSUs which can be revived will be revived. This is a statement from the central government. And where is it applicable? Only in Gujarat, madam. GSPC, which has been a SIC unit, ONGC acquired 80% of Gujarat State Petroleum Corporation for nearly 8,000 crores. ONGC even pays 1,300 crores. So this attitude is being shown to PSUs in Gujarat. Why not to the plants in Vizag? Why this stepmotherly treatment? The central government talks about one nation, one election, one nation, one ration, and so many things which should be in one nation, one constitution. I demand for one nation, one justice. If something is happening from the central government towards Gujarat in a certain way, I would request that also be happening to Vizag steel plant, which is in the state of Andhra Pradesh, madam. If the central government doesn't want to listen to me, I would like to give a cue from the former Prime Minister Atal Bihari Vajpayee ji, madam. We really miss him from the state of Andhra Pradesh, especially today, because a similar case of privatization came during the NDA one rule under the Prime Ministership of Vajpayee ji. Then Chandrababu Naidu ji, who was the Chief Minister, and Yerra Naidu ji, who was the Parliamentary Party Leader from TDP, they led a delegation from Andhra Pradesh. They met Vajpayee ji. He listened to the unions, to the leaders, to the people of Visakhapatnam and Andhra Pradesh. He understood the emotions, the sentiments.